Well, welcome to the Talyllyn Railway once again. Nearly 70 years ago, we ran a special coronation train to celebrate the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II. Now, of course, nearly 70 years later, we have another coronation coming up for Charles III. And so we thought we ought to celebrate in a similar way to what we did then. Back then, the train consisted of locomotive number 4 and the original catching stock. Now, unfortunately, locomotive number 4 is going to be out of service by the time the actual coronation takes place. So by the time you're seeing this, it is going to be in for overhaul. But we thought we would take the opportunity before it went out of service to do a little reenactment of that original train. And so we're here to do that here today. And we're here with Loco 4, original carriages as well, to celebrate the fact. But not only have we got locomotive and carriages, we've got at least one of the people who actually travelled, actually was on the footplate of the original train. And it's my privilege and pleasure to introduce Gareth Jones, who was the original fireman for the train. And we have a very famous photo of you putting the headboard on for that. Gareth, it's lovely to welcome you here again, 70 years later.
I'm most impressed with what you've done, and it's great to see it. It's totally different to the days I saw it.
Yeah.
The place has completely changed, and what a credit it is to you all.
Thank you very much.
Matt, volunteers and all, you know.
Yeah, yeah. What do you remember that day, coronation?
Not much, really. I know we had the streamers all over the side of the locomotive and the headboard and one thing another. Yeah. And we worked at 10:25 in the morning and the 14:55 in the afternoon. I think Bill Faulkner was the driver, wasn't he?
Not quite sure on that one.
David says he was.
Right.
I can't quite remember.
Yeah. And you were the fireman. And
I was.
And David Woodhouse, I think, was the guard, I think.
Could have been, yeah. Yes. I can't remember.
Yeah, yes, that's it. So there we are. So here we are, 70 years later. Well, nearly 70 years later.
It is, aren't it?
And we'd love you to put the original headboard back on the loco, just as you did.
Well, I'll try.
Thank you.
Are you ready? There we are.
That's brilliant. Thank you very much.
I hope you've been looking after it.
Yeah, it's in the safe care of the museum. They will have it straight back.
So you're expecting me to go in next? I'll tell you the full story now. It was Whitsun 1951. I was with the Boy Scouts in Harden in Cheshire. And on the Wednesday, my mother with a load of other ladies come by coach to see us, and she said that I've been in a very interesting meeting in the chapel buildings in Towyn by the town clock, and it's called the Talyllyn Railway, and they've given a very interesting account that they want to apply to open this railway. Anyhow, she said that they've noticed that I had been carrying out for Jones, the greengrocer's shop, and I used to stand on top of the bridge there and watch the morning train go out. And they wondered if I was interested in coming to work on the Talyllyn, and that was my connection. I came down and I had a little interview with Tom Rolt. And Tom said, will you come down next Wednesday evening and go with Di Jones and to have a go firing the Dolgoch up to bring glass and back? And that was the beginning of my career on the Talyllyn. But I'm thankful for Di for the training he gave me in the beginning, you know. And I must say this has stood out for me on the main line. I felt as if it was my apprenticeship to go over there, and I carried a lot of the ideas with me through the rest of my working life. In 1953, in the November, I started as a cleaner in Machynlleth, but I still continued to come down here and fire right up until 1965. But in the last couple of years, I drove. So I used to change with different firemen in Machynlleth and work the 7-5 freight from there in the morning, calling in Aberdovey and shunting here, and then doing a driving turn on here in the afternoon. In 1954, in the September, I was promoted to fireman at Tisley, Birmingham, and I did 4 months there, returned back to Machynlleth. In 1963, I passed as a past fireman and was lucky enough to be the fireman on the Royal Train, one of 8 firemen that were picked to work the Royal Train along the Cambrian here. And in 1965, I went on loan to Willesden in London for 4 months, came back. After 2 months, applied for a drive-in vacancy in Bescot in the West Midlands, transferred there, and I've been there ever since. In 2002, I was called upon with the shedmaster and said that a certain person wanted to interview me, and then, according to the interview, it was they wanted me for Royal Train duties because I was an inspector from 1990. They couldn't tell me why I was being picked, but they wanted me. And I found after that they were going to put a steam locomotive on the Royal Train for the first time in 34 years. And it was the Duchess of Sutherland, 62-33. And I took a light engine from Derbyshire down to Holyhead on the 10th of June, 2002. And then we worked the Royal Train back to Llandudno Junction, where the Royal Party, the Queen and the Duke of Edinburgh boarded the train. We took them to Crewe. And then I did another 14 years with them, handling the Royal Family all over the country. And really now I can recall working Prince Charles, as he was in them days, on 7 different occasions to different parts of the country. So I was quite proud to think that I put the board on your locomotive in 1953, and in 2002 I was engaged in Royal Train duties on the main line.
That's it.
So my training here was very important.
Well, of course, 70 years later, we had to come up with a new headboard for a new coronation. And one of our volunteers, Sarah, has been working hard, and it's now my pleasure to reveal the new 2023 headboard for the coronation of King Charles III. And to put it on our special train today, I'm going to ask our two general managers, Liz and Lorraine, to put it on for us. So there we go.
Some of us are vertically
there, there we are, all ready for a new coronation, a new era. One of the things that happened on the first running of the coronation specials was it was an offer for all children to travel free on the trains on the day. And so in celebration of that fact, we thought that today we'd actually give the opportunity for some of the local school children to come and experience a ride on the train in celebration of this year's coronation.
Houston, here we come.